Moving to America and setting up on the back of the Grammys, I definitely had a sense of urgency. It made sense for us to make the jump to have boots on the ground and provide a bit more stability for the existing roster, but also to be in a position to start working with new talent that was either based here or frequently coming through here.
We've had a lot of attention recently because of the Flume campaign across here, and it seems a lot of artists are drawn to working with FC, which is very exciting to be across in LA at a time where that's kind of brewing.
There are a lot of people doing amazing stuff here, especially in music. It's kind of the ground zero for music, at least in the Western world.
10 years ago in Los Angeles, like, the music industry in America was all in New York, so it was a lot different than coming here now, where it feels like there's so much going on. And I wouldn't say it feels crowded, but I mean, it's really competitive.
It's definitely felt like we've had to start things from scratch a little bit again, which has been fun. And yeah, also challenging as well.
It's been stressful. It's good, but like, you'll have some meetings or you'll be in certain sessions and you walk away being like, hell yeah, like, LA's the spot. And then like 2 hours later, the same day, you'll go into another session or another meeting, and it's sort of like, it can knock you down.
People know us, but it still feels like it's day dot. It feels like 2.0. It feels like a completely different business at this point. I try and remind myself it's not brain surgery. We're not saving the planet. We're engaged in making and facilitating art and helping artists flourish.
The artist projects that we have started looking at and started working on since we've gotten here, they're all super interesting. They come from different sort of backgrounds, whether that's geographically or just the stories they have to tell. Was that a teardrop in your eye? I never thought I'd see you cry. Just know whatever hurts, it's all mine. It's okay to cross, okay to cry. We've started working with Sophie. The song that she released, It's Okay to Cry, very unexpected, I think, for most of her fan base. It's not a song that I think they would have necessarily liked, even if it wasn't coming from her.
It's taking on a pop persona, and it feels like the embryonic stage of a really exciting pop project. She's been doing a lot of work with big pop stars, Charlie XCX, Rihanna.
It's an interesting narrative that I think she's telling without actually doing it lyrically. I think there's a cult nature to that project that the listeners that really sort of buy in, they're going to find meaning for themselves. The stories that Sophie is going to tell over the next couple years, I think, are going to be important. There's going to be a bunch of surprises. We're just bodies. We're just bodies in the night.
Move your bodies. Move your bodies. Wafia released a fantastic single, Bodies, this year, which was a really personal piece of music for her. Her family's Syrian, and the challenges of the situation in that part of the world.
I was feeling quite upset that day. My mum's family had been denied refugee status again, and I wanted to make something really negative, and then I kind of sat with it and decided that there's enough of that in the world. Like, I wanted to make something that could be more positive, you know, and more about the unity, and just any effort to kind of see a positive in it. Our bodies in the night.
So we're setting up a studio here in LA. That'll be the first time we have our own studio set up. It's an opportunity to put different people in the room, open them up to new experiences, and have a space where, you know, there's less pressure on it. Usually when you come to a studio environment, if you're paying for it, you're conscious of that. The hope is that having our own space, that it feels a bit safer. I hope that our thing continues to be successful, not just for us, but for our artists. I hope we're finding new talent. I hope we're going into new spaces musically.
We moved to LA this year with the kids. Like, everything that we've done for 14 years, is it? Has been really centered around Future Classic. For Nathan and I, it's our whole life. Someone's got the best of my soul. Got the best of my soul. Still upon it so long. And I'm outside, baby.
think that they've been on a bit of a rocket. You know, I think that they're having so much success with some of their artists who are doing very well in America.
My whole life I've loved record labels and I've collected vinyl and, you know, first and foremost was a DJ. As we've developed, we've found that working more holistically on the artist's career is what we're good at and what leads to better results for that artist.
I don't care if we don't win another ARIA ever again. I just want to make sure we're putting out great records. I mean, I'd love to think that we can surprise some people and do some things that no one is going to expect. I hope that the best of what we're going to do is still to come.
Chase you, we'd be up all night like the old days. You were never.